Hey, what's up? It's Don Jameson, comedian, That Metal Show, Eddie Trunk's personal masseuse. I'm here at Mira Sushi. My buddy, Chef Brian, one of the best chefs around, is going to try to teach me to cook. This isn't going to go well. I promise you that.
What is up, man?
What's up, man?
What's going on?
Good to see you.
Here you are on Taste of Metal, and it's a special episode because this is the first episode we're doing a vegetarian dish, which many people actually may not know about you, is that you're vegetarian.
25 years, and I know that seems atypical for a metalhead, but I always say if Geezer Butler could be a vegan for 30 years...
I didn't know Geezer Butler was vegan. So,
yeah.
Holy shit.
So that's cool enough for me, you know?
Yeah.
But this is, no matter how simple this is, I gotta warn you, I am to cooking what Slayer is to slow dancing.
So what we're gonna make today is spaghetti squash waffles with sauteed mushrooms and apples.
That sounds good.
All right, so yeah. First we're going to prepare our waffle batter. Flour. Baking powder. Okay. Baking soda. Brown sugar. And then we're gonna put in a hefty pinch of nutmeg, a little pinch of ginger, and another hefty pinch of cinnamon.
Okay.
And also a pinch of salt and a whisk. But the whisk is not like part of the waffle batter, just an FYI.
Oh, okay, that doesn't go in the oven.
It doesn't.
Where there's a whisk, there's a way. Sorry. Buttermilk.
Buttermilk.
Get it in there.
We're gonna put some actual butter. Dos huevos, spaghetti squash. And we're just going to whisk this together until it's nice and smooth.
Get her wet, man, get her wet. There you go, she likes that.
She loves it. All right, gonna put in 2 spoonfuls.
Okay. So far so good, this is pretty easy so far.
There, you don't want it to be super full because the batter will spread when you close the top.
Right.
Extra virgin olive oil.
Got it.
We're gonna put in our oyster mushrooms, the bigger of the two. Okay. Don't mess around with it too much because we actually want it to brown, caramelize a little. I'm gonna add in the shimeji mushrooms. And the reason why we're adding things in stages is that every time you add something, the pan's cooling down.
Gotta pace yourself.
Gotta pace yourself, you can't rush.
Right.
Rice wine.
All right, so we got a little booze in there.
A little booze. Shallots.
Oh. What's the difference between shallots and onions?
Shallots are much smaller, and I would say that they're a little sweeter in flavor profile.
So smaller and sweeter.
Yes.
Like Danzig in a bonnet.
Exactly like that.
Okay.
Slice some apples. Throw that right in there. Maple syrup, just a hint. Turn off the heat. Now we're going to add our parsley. We're gonna put it right on top.
That's a weird combination.
You made
it. But it seems like it works. And it looks beautiful.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Thank you. I try to take care of myself.
But part of cooking is the presentation, right?
Well, you eat with your eyes first.
Yes, you're beautiful as well. But I mean, eat with your eyes. But trust me, after I cook my batch, you're gonna wanna give it to Stevie Wonder.
So it's a mix of savory and sweet.
Mm-hmm.
It's not overly sweet. That's the purpose of the dish is not to be overly sweet. You actually want it to be more on the savory side.
Let me just have one more bite.
Taste of the dish. I'm gonna have to step out of the kitchen now. Good luck, sir.
I'm by myself on this?
You're totally by yourself.
All right, summer squash waffles, Don Jameson style. Look at that. That was a party in the 80s right there. Extra virgin olive oil. All right, I did it out of order, but I caught myself. I caught my mistake early. Ah! Now I have a secret weapon. Grated Parmesan. He's fucked, okay? Wait till he tastes my pancakes with the grated Parmesan. Watch this. He won't even know I did this. Guarantee your highest score ever on this show. All right, Big Shot, come on back. Wait till you taste how you really cook summer squash waffles with mushrooms.
You've seen me make the dish. I've explained it to you A to Z, and here it is.
That's what I came up with.
This is what you came up with.
I'm feeling pretty good about it. All right, go ahead, visually.
All right, it has all the ingredients of my dish, including an extra one that I actually forgot. So I'm gonna give you an automatic +1 point for that. Let's taste it.
In a lot of ways, you sabotaged me. You gave me too many ingredients, knowing that I'd be a rookie and put them all on top. And you didn't even slice up the onions the right way.
Well, but you were supposed to slice up the onions. I sliced it for
That's
you so that...
Metal Injection didn't tell me anything about slicing, and they don't have insurance, I don't want to be handling knives.
The mushrooms and the apples and the shallots were not cooked long enough on the pan. It doesn't have enough caramelization.
Yeah, I agree.
For this, out of 10, I'm gonna have to give you, you got a +1. You got a +1 because of the farm. I'm gonna have to give you a 7.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah. Here, the waffle's good, although misshapen. It was just really what I had to dock the points for.
Okay.
was the mushroom and the shallots were not cooked long
right.
enough.
Right, and the misshapen wallet.
And the misshapen wallet, yeah. leather always sucks in a waffle.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. We'll tackle wallet cooking the next time I come
next
on the
time.
Show.
Yeah, absolutely.
But
yeah.
In the meantime, let's go get a beer, man.
Yeah, let's do this.
You give me a 7, I could buy you a beer.
All right, let's do it. Fuck this restaurant.